Welcome, guys, to the first episode of Tea Kurals. If you listen to our introduction episode, this is the episode, this is the series where we learn Tirukkural together. This episode, we are going to discuss the infamous first Kural. Adi is here as well. Adi, say hello.
Hey, guys. So we're here to discuss Tirukkural, our interpretation. Hopefully, listen to your interpretation also. I think, yeah, Puri.
Let's start. Let's not waste any time. Let's start over. So the first Kural goes like this. Agara mudala yelthallam, Adi Bhagavan mudatre ulagu.
Yeah. So, what do you think? What is your interpretation of it? Like, what do you think? So, what is the translation actually first?
Let's talk about the translation, Adi. Do you have the translation on you?
So the translation given by Gio Pope, who is a very notable Tamil scholar. He is given the translation as A, as the first letter. Every speech maintains the primal deity is first through all the world domains. So I think what he's trying to say is, like the letter A, or in English A, as it's the first letter that you learn, or the first letter in the language, the primal deity is first through all the world's domains. Whatever the primal deity refers to.
And first of all, I think it's one of the few Tirukkurals, Adi, we talked about this before starting the episode. Few Tirukkurals we can itself decrypt without translation, Adi.
Yeah. Your basic knowledge of Tamil, I think this is a Tirukkural that you can understand and translate by yourself.
Translate by yourself. But yeah. Okay, let's not waste more time. This is supposed to be a short episode. So my personal interpretation of this, so I am an atheist. So I don't believe that there was an Adi Bhagavan, there was a God that created everything. But part of the beauty of Valluvar's work is that we can just replace things with what we know today. Like if I replace God with the Big Bang or the primal deity in G. Pope's translation with the Big Bang or atoms, then it again makes sense, right? A is the first letter in the language, and the atoms are the smallest or the fundamental thing or the first thing in nature. And I think that's very beautiful. Adi, what about you?
See, for me, I think I find beauty with the second line, where it talks about there's this one deity which unifies all the earth, right? And I think each person will have their own. When you hear this, I think based on your own ideology, you'll have your own philosophy on what that thing is. While a person like Newton or like person who is very into physics would say the primal deity would be mass, like what we call today.
Oh, Newton would not say that. Newton's definitely a little Christian.
I mean, yeah, but I'm saying somebody in that
Periyar side
would say gravity. While Periyar or a philosopher would say the humanity, like in Anbe Sivam, love is that deity. On the other hand, you could say it's time. Time is the ultimate deity. The thing that we observe everything through is we observe everything in the universe through time. So this is a Kural which could be interpreted in any way that you want, depending on what your deity is going to be, the primal deity, whatever the primal deity, the unchanging deity that
you think
it rules through all domains.
That's very beautiful. And one more thing I'd like to talk about before we close the episode is that it's very meta. It is the first Kural. It talks about the first letter. It talks about what is very primal. And that's a great way to start out such a massive body of work. I like the meta-ness in the Kural as well.
Yeah, it's questioning itself. It starts with saying how everything starts.
That's really wonderful. Okay, with those thoughts, we'd like to finish our first episode of Tea Kurals. Please share your thoughts with us through our Instagram or wherever, and like we'd love to continue this discussion. See you on the next episode of Tea Kurals. Thank you.